Now here we are to have a look at Roland's GoPiano 88 full-length piano keyboard with touch-sensitive but not actually weighted piano keys. First of all, we'll hear it through the headphone socket and then we'll hear it through its own little built-in speakers. Piano voice, the first of four voices. Now we have the electric piano. We have the church organ. And we have some rather nice strings. Now, when it comes to strings, there are two ways that manufacturers have of treating what happens when you use the sustain pedal. And some manufacturers, it works like an organ, so the strings are just there until you release the pedal and then they cut off suddenly. But here, if I play a string chord and use the pedal, yeah, it fades away very nicely, which that's the way I prefer it. So that's a good point, a plus on Roland's part. Now, you've only got four voices, but you can have two at once. Here we have piano, and if I want the strings at the same time, I hold piano and then press strings. And as you can hear, you get a lot of piano, not much strings, but they are there. If you want it the other way around, well, you start with strings, you hold it, and then you press piano. And we should get a lot of strings and a barely perceptible piano. Really barely perceptible. I think they could have got the balance a wee bit better. Now, we have an electric piano. And the same thing would apply. I want a little strings. Well, that's that's a bit better. The balance there is a little better. The pipe organ, again, if you want to mix that with the strings, what would we have? We could have... strings barely audible. Do it the other way around. Start with strings, add in the organ. Much better that way around. So you have all those different combinations that you can do. If you are a piano teacher, then the twin piano function splits the keyboard around about the middle here. Ah, there we are. So middle C now becomes the highest C for one of you. And you've got a shorter piano up here. So you could actually tutor your pupil side by side without them having to translate in their heads from the octave you're playing in to the octave you're expecting them to play in. Good feature. There's our metronome. Yeah. What do you expect from metronomes? They don't have much imagination, do they? No. Now, you can adjust various functions. So this little button here, you hold it down, and you won't be able to see it, but written above, some of the keys are, well, the metronome, the beats in the bar, the tempo, the amount of reverb that you've got. Now let's go back to our church organ for a moment. Now that's the standard setting. If I want to get rid of the reverb, I keep pressing the key until it stops giving me those little beeps. Now there should be no reverb. Other way around, let's have the maximum, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 beeps. And suddenly, you're in the cathedral. What more could you want? With the piano at maximum, it sounds... Again, using that little button, we have four different settings for how it responds to your touch, from fixed, which is what you'd really want for the organ sound, up to you've got to hit it with a sledgehammer. And at the top end, you have tuning and you have a transposer. Again, very simple to use. What are we on just now? There's F. Hit the transposer. Play F and we hear G. Ah, very good. And you've got to remember to put it back when you're finished with it. Otherwise, the next song could be a screecher. Now, that's enough of its sounds through the headphones. Let's have a listen to what it sounds like through its own speakers. Piano 1. Piano. Organ. And strings. Now, overall construction, the keys are rather nice. There are no sharp edges. I've got an 88 note Alesis Q88, and the key edges were so sharp I actually had to take a file and round them all off. Not the sort of usual thing you have to do with pianos. Mechanically, right, if I turn the volume down, how much sound is the keyboard itself making? All keyboards will make some sort of noise. The question is, can you live with it? They either click or they thump, or they do both. What else can we say about it? It's not too heavy. Round the back, you've only got four sockets there. You have your power input, your headphone output, sustain pedal input, which you get a small sustain pedal supplied with the piano, and your USB MIDI if you want to hook up to a computer. I have hooked this up to my computer, which has the Abbey Road, the Gadditon Abbey Road Yamaha piano in it, and absolutely no problems at all. The computer recognised the keyboard without me actually having to even do anything. So that's a good thing on it. So there you go, the Roland GoPiano 88.